So, I think you have a microphone maybe to help you. Paul is here. Surprised that Paul would have a question. Do you guys have a question? Anybody else? But. We can get you one. No problem.
Let's talk about the cabin sensing system. Any sort of time frame? There's been a lot of technology, like I talked about over the years, and nothing's made it into production.
The cabin sensing, we're talking back to Zach Gibbs' presentation? Yeah. And first of all, Zach, to you and to your team, I think it's amazing. And he mentioned several people's names, Steve Bajra and Brian Kursar, and a load of people who've been a part of this. This actually came, the solution actually came from a summit, we'll call it. What do we call it? The
hackathon.
To try to look into solving some of the concerns that we heard. And at the time, there was a couple of the children who had, unfortunately, had passed away in a heated car. From a timing standpoint, is that?
Legally, we can say this is a proof of concept, but come down and check it out. And we hope to get it into an early version of an autonomous vehicle to start with.
So nothing before autonomous. You wouldn't have it in a standard
production. Well, it's still a proof of concept on the integration. There's things like that we have to figure out. For example, if a bird flies by and lands on the window, does it activate all this stuff? And do you want that to happen? We've got to work that part out. But it's still early days. But we'll show you the whole concept downstairs that's working.
And you need to check out the concept. And I think the proof of concept will get you excited about what it can be and will be. And it's clearly, we're not about ready to show something here in front of you all if we're not confident we're going to be able to use it. So no timing discussions yet, but it's a really incredible advancement. So next question over here.
Emmy Hall from CNET. Can you guys explain a little bit more about the motorcycle detection in the safety system 3.0?
So, I think the fundamental technology is not so different from the safe exit that you see in the current NX that we just launched earlier this year. So, using the cameras on the vehicle can detect if there's bicyclists or motorcycle coming down the side. In the NX deployment, in terms of what we have in the vehicle right now, it'll actually warn you so you don't actually open the door into a vehicle that's on its way on the side.
Okay, so it's just like regular safe exit, but now it's working for motorcycles and cyclists.
Yeah, I think we're constantly looking for ways to kaizen and improve the technology that we have in our vehicles, and then as we deploy them in successive vehicles across the lineup, to try to make that technology better.
Cool. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Doran. Thank you.
We're hearing a lot about the verge of commercialization of autonomous services in San Francisco by Cruise, and also it's been going on for a while now with Waymo in Chandler, Arizona. Can you give us an update on where Toyota is in the commercialization of any kind of autonomous service, where you are in this process?
Doran, I think it's interesting to see what's happening in San Francisco. How many of you here from, anybody from San Francisco? In the area you live in there? No, it's interesting. So Doran, here, let me give you the end of the answer. The answer is I have no update for you on specifically what Toyota's gonna be doing. I think it's important to understand with some of the shared services and some of the autonomous programs, is there are so many other elements that have to still be solved before you can really talk about what Toyota's gonna do, because there's so many things insurance and you know, city governments and things that are still years away is really what I'd say. Now, some of these groups that are working in San Francisco, you mentioned Chandler, there's a couple others that are developing. One in, I think it's Colorado Springs, is about ready to launch. There are all these test programs. As of right now, we have nothing to announce of anything we're testing on with a city or municipality or with any other company. I will simply tell you as we continue to pursue our advancements in technology, that we're excited about some of the opportunities that we have and some of the companies that are coming to us that would like to chat with us about partnering.
Yeah, I'll add, we have a full presentation tomorrow about our partner at Aurora around autonomous, so we'll dive a little bit deeper into that.
Okay, right here.
Well, I was wondering if you could speak to the logic of the 6-speed automatic in the 500H, because this is quite a different hybrid drivetrain than Lexus has used in the past, and what was the decision process behind using that and not the, the two motor system that you've used before, the Lexus Energy Drive?
So, the first thing we're gonna try to create the more direct feel onto the hybrid. So we are looking for another value for the hybrid powertrain with the hand to drive. So that mainly we are focusing on that direct feel onto the hybrid. That's nice.
Hello, Paul Foss, Clean Technica. We specialize in electrification, and I'm obviously thrilled to see, you know, all the electrification of the RX line. But what we worry about is if any of them are compliance cars or low volume, are they available in 50 states? Can you give us an idea of, you know, the volume across those? Because a lot of times something exciting comes out like the RAV for Prime, but nobody can get it.
Okay. Well, where were you like 20 years ago when we were introducing electric cars and nobody was thought they were cool? That's what I want to know. Huh? It's a great question. So here's the deal. Every OEM is dealing with the same concerns. You have a limited number or a currently still a finite number of batteries and their uses. The biggest issue that we have to continue to look at, and I am going to change your question a little bit before I try to answer it a little bit more. What's the goal? What's the goal in the industry? Is it to bring out more BEVs? Is it to bring out more plug-ins? If the goal is to carbon neutrality, what's the best way to get to carbon neutrality? And I think, and I've done some stuff, so I know where you're coming from. We want that to be 50 state, we want it to be to every person, we want everybody to participate in the direction or intentionality to become carbon neutral. And every single competitor in this industry is coming up with a different way to try to solve that. You've heard from us, whether it's a Toyota or Lexus, our goal will be to continue to listen to the marketplace, to deliver powertrains that answer the needs of every kind of person in every kind of market. All the way through hybrid, plug-in, fuel cell technology, battery electric. And we will continue to do that because we believe that that's what the consumer is asking for. Not only the choice, but the different use needs that they have. So with that, we're not going to provide today the exact number of volume of where we're going here. But I will tell you, that is our goal and our intentionality, is for carbon neutrality. What we promised in 2017, before anybody was talking about it, when we had our plan about the carbon neutral, where we were going, and the 90% reduction, we are still on that path. We will deliver on the promises that we made to the globe, and we will continue to do that. And we will continue to see how many people we can bring along into that NH state or any part of the North America that you're living.
The only thing I want to add to that is, from a brand perspective, electrification, as you heard Sato-san say, is a foundational component of our marketing strategy, our brand strategy moving forward. And you know what you can expect to see when we launch the RX, the major media support behind it, paid media support behind it. We want to talk to the proliferation of the model, the fact that there's more grades, the fact that we have more electrification, the fact that it's not just about better efficiency, but also fun to drive. You know, that peak torque at zero RPM that comes with an electric motor, and combining that with efficient gas engine is part of that Lexus driving signature and the fun that comes with the Lexus lineup. So that's an important piece of it as well. You're welcome.
Yeah, one hand here right through the mic. Are you ready, microphone? Larry, go ahead.
Sato-san, can you talk a little bit about how Lexus is going to attract all these younger buyers? Right now you have a very old demographic. And I know Jack had to feel a little tug at his chest when he saw that boomer graphic. But I guess, can you talk about what you do to attract younger buyers into a luxury brand that they may not be able to afford?
Yeah, thank you very much. So, firstly, we are very much so much passionate about making a better car. That's the starting point of our brand. So, younger buyer, older buyer, it's not the matter. So, we are the automotive company. So, we will bring the ever better car. That's our foundation. But on top of that, we need to create something different, something new experience with car, with younger buyers. So sometimes it's for the dining or some fashion, the art, and everything, including the car life. That would be nice. That has been a presentation to you. So we are our strong point, one of our strong point is the dealer service. The dealer service can provide you more the unique experience for the younger buyer. Now we are prepare for that, the new generation.
Yeah, Larry, it's a great question. And it's an area where my team has been very focused over the last year to try to change perceptions and really invite a younger consumer to really take a look at Lexus. And I'll start with, again, going back to my presentation, the data. If you look at why Gen Z, Gen Y, and even Gen X consumers were rejecting, avoiding, and defecting the Lexus brand, one of the biggest reasons that continually popped up, regardless of the demographic group, is technology. And I wouldn't feel confident going to be the 100 Thieves exclusive auto partner if I didn't have the foundation of the phenomenal product and technology that Sato-san and his team are providing. Great example of that. You know, last year we told you that you're saying goodbye to the joystick and the touchpad, and you guys gave us a round of applause right through the phone. What did we replace that with? We replaced it with Lexus interface. Immersive, that 14-inch screen when you sit into the NX, when you sit inside this vehicle, it just screams quality, but it screams immersive and intuitive technology. And it's simple to use, it's simple to figure out. So that's why, no surprise, so we feature so strongly in marketing. Whether it's digital, whether it's linear, we're out there telling the story of Lexus interface. You know, we talked about safe exit, another great technology that keeps you safe. These are things that help us connect with these younger consumers, along with the partnerships like we talked about, and you know, really being focused on finding ways to connect with those consumers with the media that they're choosing.
Last piece that I'm just gonna to add to my excitement of where we're going, because every single OEM, everyone is going after the younger crowd, right? Y or Z, it doesn't matter. IS comes out, lowers the age of the buyer. LX, NX, we are on a really good pattern coming out with RX. There is a momentum around that that I'm excited for Lexus. So, Mark, do you have a question?
Yeah, thank you, Jen.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know. Sorry, I thought I had the microphone. Sorry, whoever was here had a microphone. I'm sorry.
Sorry about that.
Okay, well, thank you.
Mark, go ahead.
Thank you very much, Jay. Mark Phelan, Detroit Free Press. The RZ450E, the steer-by-wire system, two questions about that. Is it Federal Motor Vehicle Safety Standard compliant? And what kind of backup have you got for it? Is there a mechanical system, redundant electronics? What is the fail-safe?
First question is, are we having anybody from our team a drive-by-wire presentation at all? Do we know?
Not this time.
Not this time, okay. Just want to be sure.
So the first question, answer to you, first question, so of course we checked all the regulation. So that we passed all the related regulation. And also our fail-safe system, and redundancy, the duplicated the control or the how should I think about redundancy.
It's a full redundancy system with two components of each. So if one goes down,
the backup.
No mechanical
electronics.
Yes.
All electronics.
Thank you. Very good.
Who do we miss over here? Did I know?
Right here. One more.
One more?
Yep.
Last one. Very good.
Yeah. Hey, how are you?
So I had a question about the new infotainment system you guys are talking about. The current setup, if you're not subscribed to something like the navigation setup, you get prompts that ask you if you want to sign up. Is it still going to do that? Are you still going to prompt people if they don't have a service, if they want to sign up, or is that going to be more a user can opt out and not have to see those?
That is a great question.
Thanks.
That's why I'm going to look over and see if Zach, if you have a microphone, to answer that next good question. Yeah, that is the first time I've heard that question specifically.
I don't know.
Sharon's here. Sharon, where are you hiding?
I don't know if I should walk all the way.
Come on up.
I guess that's a formality. The other new system that we released, you know, for us to release, the system was a big jump for us, as we know. We got a lot of clashes with Touch Pad Race. Thanks for that. We're monitoring the market, and we're getting lots of good feedback. Not only from our customers, we're getting feedback from blogs, we're getting feedback from dealers. We're looking at everything. We just released our first over-the-air update, which fixed a few little bugs that were annoying to people. So we're gonna keep updating the system, and we are looking at exactly that, the registration process. I always streamline that as well. So yeah.
Bless you.
Exactly. Your reason.
Because our last question. Or you're asking one more. Okay.
I'll be honest. I'm pretty shocked that that's RX. We've owned every generation. I guess my question is, like, internally, like, what is your challenge to say, hey, this is our bestseller. We're taking a big risk here, or do we play it safe? Like, what really drove internally to make a decision?
I'll start by saying RX, when it started, 1998 was a big risk. And some of you who were there thought we were foolish for even starting it. And be honest, you asked with yourself, you weren't so sure. We took a bold step there. And as we've gone, by adding a hybrid engine to the vehicle, that was the first. And people were like, what are you really doing? So some of these, RX has been the platform for Lexus to take, it's always calculated risk. But you're not stepping out and doing something a little bit more aggressive. Where are you going? With that, maybe I can ask Mr. Sato.
So the beginning of our project, so we're talking with the actual, how we manage the core model for the Lexus, very, very, very important project for us. So that actual say just one thing, do the challenge, no compromise. So he said, so far that we are thinking that it's like a Kaizen. We have many voice from the customer, so we need some upgrade, we need some improvement, everything covered with Kaizen. But that's the starting point of the Alex, but he destroyed that idea. Yeah, that's true. he requesting us to create a new standard. So we are looking for a better driving experience. This is the greatest one, but Lexus need one to create our clear character for the driving experience. And then the other is the design. We need to create some unique one for the core model. So these two is the challenge for us to break through the current one. That's fun.
I appreciate the question because RX, and as many people see it, it's kind of like,
really?
All right, we're going to keep pushing it. And I think not just in RX, but in all of our lineup, including some of the other products we talked about, BEVs and others that are coming. So with that, I'll just say thank you and let Vinay close us out.
Hey, I just want to say thank you to everyone. Thanks for spending the time with us today and asking these questions.